Good morning, children. Welcome back to the SBR online classes. So I am here back again with the social studies part, that is geography. And in that lesson, we were studying from 3 days, we were studying about the lithosphere. And today we shall proceed with the remaining part of the lesson. I think it will not be completed today also because it's a very lengthy lesson. So how much is possible today? Yeah, I'll try to do that. And in the next class, we will continue. So here, now, before I could proceed towards the further part of the lesson, which I had left yesterday, again, once again, we'll have a small recap of the previous 3 days' classes. Okay? You all must and should have the textbook with your children. Because after a little explanation, I'm going to take that textbook for you all to read. I will show you the reading also, so that you can understand what is being explained by me. So lithosphere, we have studied. What is this lithosphere? It is the solid most outer layer of the earth. That is called as a lithosphere. Meaning of lithosphere. That earth's interior . Then we have studied about the rocks and types of rocks. Then yesterday we have studied about the forces of Earth's crust. Lithosphere. The meaning of lithosphere, we said that the outermost solid layer of the earth is called as the lithosphere, right? So we will take this as the solid most outer layer. This is called as the lithosphere. The outermost solid layer of the earth is called as a lithosphere. Litho means rock, sphere means layer. Life exists on this layer with the help of hydrosphere and atmosphere. This we have studied. And then about Earth's interior. That is coming back. The Earth's interior. What is there inside the depth of the Earth? Human beings are very eager to know what is there in the Earth's interior. Research have been made by the human beings and they came to know that Earth is composed or Earth contains several minerals and materials inside the earth, and based on the composition of the materials and the physical state of the earth, the physical matter of the earth, earth's interior is divided into 3 different layers. We have studied first one is the crust, the mantle, and the core. So here, this part we call it as the crust. I told you this is about 60 kilometers from depth from the surface of the earth. Then we have studied about the mantle. This is 2900 kilometers from the surface of the earth, and then lastly we have the core. So there are 3 different layers or 3 different slabs into the earth's interior. Those are called as the crust, the mantle, and the core. The crust is the topmost layer of the earth's interior, which again contains 2 other more layers. One is called as the outer layer and the other one is called as the inner layer. The outer layer is rich in silica and aluminium and it is called as continental part. And inner layer is having silica and magnesium, that is called as a oceanic crust, or we call it as a oceanic part. Then mantle is also very rich in other materials which are in the semi-liquid form, and that contains the magma. So mantle contains the magma, or the molten materials into the earth's interior is there in the mantle. and the depth of this mantle is 2900 kilometers from the surface of the earth. Then the last one is the core. This is the last layer. It also is very rich in minerals inside the earth's interior. So this we have studied, and the formation rocks and the types of rocks we have studied. Rocks are the inorganic solid substances that are being formed inside the earth's crust, and also some rocks are formed above the surface of the earth. So there are three types of rocks we have studied. The first one is called as igneous rocks. Igneous rocks. Then second one we have studied as sedimentary rocks. And third one is metamorphic rocks. How igneous rocks are being formed? Igneous rocks are being formed with the help of the fire, with the help of the molten magma that gets boiled inside the earth crust, and that which comes out in the, when it reaches to the surface of the earth, that becomes the extrusive igneous rock. And the materials which are still inside the earth of the earth, and there it forms the rock with the muddy materials and goes and fixes up into the different layers of the earth's crust, there it forms the intrusive igneous rocks. Understood? So igneous rocks are the rocks that are being formed from the fire that is there in the mantle or the magma. By the cooling down of the magma is heated into the earth's crust, and then it cools down, and then it forms the rock. So two types of rocks are formed. One is intrusive igneous rock, that is the rocks are formed when the molten magma does not reach the surface of the earth, but it gets stepped layer by layer inside the earth's crust, then it forms the intrusive igneous rocks. Extrusive igneous rocks is when the molten magma reaches to the surface of the earth and then gets spreads all over on the earth, surface of the earth, and gets hardened after the molten magma cools down. Those rocks are called as the extrusive igneous rocks. Then comes the sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks are being formed from the small fragments of the igneous rocks. The igneous rocks, when they break up, when the wind blows very hardly, and when they break, what is that we say, breaks up, or when they hit each other, then what happens? The small fragments will be fallen here and there, and with the help of water bodies, the water bodies take away along with the water all the soil and the mud and the small fragments that are fallen on the surface of the earth in the form of igneous rocks, and they go and settle down. So when this muddy material goes and settles down with the water, then they become as a sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks, it is derived from the Greek word sedimentum, which means settle down. That is, sedimentary rocks are made or being formed from the small fragments of the igneous rocks. Then comes the metamorphic rocks. Where, how metamorphic rocks are formed, I have told yesterday. Metamorphic rocks are being formed by heat and pressure. By heat and pressure, they are being formed with the, on the parts of the igneous rocks and sedimentary rocks. When they get heated and pressurized into the earth's interior, then metamorphic rocks are being formed. I gave you an example that if I want to prepare rice to eat, then I have to take the grains and put it in the pressure cooker and place the pressure cooker on the gas stove. So when the gas cooker gets heated and with the help of the fire, so same like that, earth's interior is boiling inside. It has got fire into the earth's interior. When the earth's interior gets boiled, it puts pressure on the surroundings that is there. So what is there in the surroundings? Mud is there, some small stones are there, any other minerals are there. So all these minerals, they get boiled and they come out, and then they are forming the metamorphic rock. So same is the example I have given you. Place the pressure cooker to prepare the rice. When it gets heated, when the cooker gets heated with the pressure, it gives or it whistles out, stating that the thing is over or rice is being prepared. So heat produces pressure. Understood? Heat is giving you the pressure. So with the help of the heat and the pressure, metamorphic rocks are being formed. Okay, these are the things that we have covered on the previous 3 days of the class. Now we are proceeding with the other part that I have discussed yesterday. What is that? About the forces of the earth crust. What are the forces of the earth crust? We have studied there are two types of forces of the earth crust. One is called as endogenic forces and the other one is called as a exogenic forces. Endogenic forces are also called as internal forces and exogenic forces are also called as external forces. Right? So exogenic and endogenic forces. Internal forces are those forces, or what we call endogenic forces are the forces that are acting from the earth interior. Understanding? So I write here endogenic forces. Endogenic forces, or we call it as internal forces. Endogenic forces are the forces that are acting from the interior of the earth. Inside the earth, some pressure is being put, some forces are there that are acting inside the earth only. Those forces are called as endogenic forces, or we call it as internal forces. What can be the example of these endogenic forces? Those examples are volcanoes, earthquakes, volcanoes, earthquakes, etc. Now let us define about the external forces also. Then in detail I will be telling you about the types of volcanoes. Then what are these exogenic forces? Exogenic forces are the forces that are acting on the surface of the earth. Okay, so those are called as external forces, or we call it as exogenic forces. The example of this we can say as wind, temperature, wind temperature, glaciers, snowfall, rainfall, etc. So there are two types of forces in the earth's crust. One is endogenic forces and the other one is the exogenic forces. Endogenic forces are the forces that are acting in the interior of the earth, that is inside the crust of the earth, and the examples are volcanoes, earthquakes. no doubt all these endogenic forces will again come out in the form of external forces, right? That will be studied in detail. Exogenic forces are the forces that are acting on the surface of the earth. Those are wind, temperature, rainfall, all these things. Now we shall go back again to the endogenic forces. In endogenic forces, we are going to study about volcanoes and earthquakes. So, volcano. What is a volcano? About volcano. What is a volcano? A volcano is a vent, or you call it as an opening. In the earth crust, through which water material erupts suddenly. Erupts means that comes out. Okay. So volcano. What is volcano means? It is a force that is happening inside the earth. That is the boiling of the magma. The fire, which is very red in color inside the earth's interior, that gets boiled inside, boiled. And then when the pressure, it is more pressurized, it comes out in the opening or in the, a volcano is a vent in the earth's crust through which water material erupts suddenly. So diagrammatically I will show you here, you can see. Suppose say for example, I draw like this in this shape for you. We'll take it as an earth only. Right? These are earth only. This, you see that? So there are three different layers, right? Three different layers are there. But what is happening here in the crust of the earth? That is here. This is the layer crust. This is crust. In the crust, what happens? Crust, mantle, and core is there. So, molten magma is here. This molten magma or the fire that is getting boiled inside the earth's interior, and it takes, the boiling is going on here in a very high temperature, and then this molten magma, suddenly what happens? It is coming out. Through an opening. So this we call it as the mouth, or what you call the, where from the place if this volcano comes out or the magma comes out, that is called as a crater, and this is called as a vent, right? So this is a molten magma, complete red fire is there. This molten magma or the magma which is coming out from the mantle or from the crust, this is called as a volcano vent. So from where it is coming, this vent, it is an opening here. This one is an opening here, and greater is the place from where the, or the place where the point, you can say, where the molten material erupts suddenly, that is called as a, this much in this part we call it as a crater, and this we call it as a vent. The molten magma is getting passed over through this vent. It is an opening that is coming out and reaches on the surface of the earth. So this is called as a volcano. understanding children, it's not that difficult for you to understand, because all these are the natural things that we face. We listen in the news and all, what is earthquake, what is tsunami, what is volcano, so and so things happen in different countries. I'm making you understand all these natural disasters, how it happens, because you should be aware of all these things as a part of your study and also for a general knowledge. Understand? So volcano is nothing but the internal force where the molten magma is getting boiled inside and suddenly it comes out in the form of lava. The molten magma, it comes out in the form of lava, that is called as a volcano. And this lava gets spread all over in the surroundings of the earth, which causes mass destruction to the mankind. Understanding? So this volcano is a volcano or a mass destruction to the human beings, to the mankind, because earth can also, it can balance how much it has to balance. It's a natural disaster. So when the things are going beyond the limit, you see that earth crust we have studied, it has got lot of temperature, lot of pressure, lot of boilingness, and also different types of materials are present there inside the earth. So when this magma material or molten magma gets boiled, then it ejects out, or when it want to just come out of it through the vent or opening, then that is called as a lava, and it spreads on the different surfaces of the earth. And when the lava falls on the different surfaces of the earth in the form of fire, it causes lot of destruction to the mankind. It can be destruction to the buildings, it can be destruction to the forest, or we see in the news that that so and so building got destroyed with the fire, so and so building fell down, or so and so building we could see the fire in the forest. In the Africans we have seen, so all these things are happening because the forces that are there in the earth's interior, suddenly because of the pressure, they come out and they destroy the surroundings or the living beings on the earth. So these are called as the endogenic forces. So one example of endogenic force, what we have studied, a volcano. Okay, then there are different types of volcanoes also. So what are the different types of volcanoes, we'll see here. The different types of volcanoes. There are basically three types of volcanoes. One is active volcano. Dormant volcano. And extinct volcano. So this active volcano means there is continuous eruption of the lava. In active volcanoes we see there is continuous eruption. It means that lava is coming out of the earth crust continuously. There is continuous eruptions of lava from the earth's crust. In the dormant volcano, what happens? The lava is there. Means again and again. It takes place once, again and again. Once it takes place, and then it repeats again. That is called as a dormant volcanoes. So those are the volcanoes that erupt in future. They erupt in future. Dormant volcanoes erupt in future. Then what are extinct volcanoes? These are the volcanoes that are not active again and again. These volcanoes, they are not active again and again. And these type of volcanoes usually take place in the remote geological periods. Understanding? So here three types of volcanoes are there. One is the active volcano, dormant volcano, and the extinct volcano. Active volcano. In active volcanoes, we are seeing there is continuous eruptions. It means that lava is coming out continuously from the earth crust. Dormant volcano means when once the lava comes out and that lava spreads out on the earth again and again, or it causes in future, it causes damage, or they erupt in future. They get stored here and then they erupt in the future. Then extinct volcano, they are not active again and again. Understanding? So these are the types of volcanoes. Then we come to the page number 175. You see, we'll be learning about the types and forces of the earth. Yesterday we have gone till there, and now I'll be telling you the types of volcanoes. Active volcanoes, which constantly eject lava. So this I'm reading you from the textbook. Written in a simple word. In the textbook, it is given you in very depth of the topic. So in short, I am explaining you, means for you to make easy, I am explaining in a very easiest way. So here, active volcanoes, volcanoes which constantly eject lava, gases, ashes are known as the active volcanoes. These are about 600 active volcanoes in the world. So there are 600 active volcanoes out there in the world. And Strange Strombili, Strange Etna in Italy, St. Helens in USA, Mauna Leona in Hawaii Islands. So all these are the active volcanoes that are ejecting lava continuously in the world. Then dormant volcanoes. Dormant volcanoes are those volcanoes which have erupted in the past and are likely to erupt again. So which have happened earlier, but still in future they are going to eject lava. Those type of volcanoes are called as the dormant volcanoes, but have remained inactive for fairly long period. It means that they are silent for long period and then once again they get erupted on the surface of the earth. Then extinct volcanoes. Extinct volcanoes are those which are active in the remote geological periods and these are not likely to be active once again. So these are called as the extinct volcanoes. Then what are the volcanic materials that we have to study? The materials ejecting out from the volcanoes are of three types. What are the materials? I say that volcano is there, molten magma is falling on the surface of the earth. So what are the contents of it, or how, what are, whether they are in the liquid or the solid or what form they are? Solid volcanic bombs, cinders, scorio, pumice, dust, ash. So in the form of solid, all these things are there. Then liquid, that is lava. Gases, sulfur, hydrogen, carbon dioxide. So when the lava comes out of the earth's crust, it contains the solid, liquid and gases form. So in the solid, it contains the volcanic bombs. In the liquid, it contains the lava. And in the gases, it contains hydrogen, carbon dioxide and sulfur. Then distribution of volcanoes. What is this distribution of volcanoes? Volcanoes occur in many regions of the world. So in many different countries, volcanoes takes place, including islands, young mountain ranges and plateaus of the continents. Most important regions are the circumpacific belt or Pacific ring of fire, coastal margins of the Pacific Ocean consisting of Philippines, Japan, USA, Central America, South America and so on. So where distribution of volcanoes means in which are the places these volcanoes are being taking place in the world. So I told you that is circumpacific belt. Then in the mid-Atlantic belt, that is Iceland and West Indies. Mid-continental belt, that is in Italy, Spain. So these are the countries where there is chances of volcanoes taking place. Then earthquakes. Then coming back to earthquake, we'll study what is an earthquake, the definition of earthquake, and how does earthquake take place, or what are the reasons for earthquake to take place, and what happens when earthquakes takes place. So this we'll be learning now. Earthquake are nothing but the continuous shocks on the surface of the earth. They are the sudden shocks or series of tremors that takes place due to a sudden movement of crustal rocks generated within the crust or the mantle. So that is called as a earthquake. So what is earthquake? We'll really study here now. What are earthquakes? In the next book, it is given children here. Earthquake is a shock or a series of shocks or tremors due to a sudden movement of crustal rocks generated within the crust or the mantle. The point of origin of the earthquake in the earth's crust is called as the seismic focus or hypocenter. This I'll tell you in a simple way. What is the definition of earthquake and where does it happen and what are the points? The point on the earth's surface vertically above the seismic focus is called as epicenter. The scientific study of earthquake is called as seismology, and the origin, time, velocity and direction of seismic waves are recorded by an instrument called as seismograph. So now just I'll give you an explanation of it. As it is given in the textbook, the serious shocks or the tremors due to sudden movements of the crustal rocks generated within the crust or the mantle is called as an earthquake. So in a simple way, I will tell you, the movement of the lithospheric plates causing vibration on the surface of the earth are called earthquakes. Okay, the movement of the lithospheric plates causing vibrations on the surface of the earth are called as earthquakes. So this is an example of an endogenic force. What is endogenic force? I told you, endogenic forces are the internal forces that are acting inside the earth's crust, understanding children, and produces some sudden movements on the surface of the earth. So this is earthquake. The movement of the lithospheric plates causing vibrations on the surface of the earth are called as earthquake. As we have studied that the earth's crust is divided into different layers of slab. What are those we studied? Crust, mantle and core. See, our whole lesson, this part is different from this earth's interior only. So this is crust, this is mantle. Earthquake volcano is also happening because of the earth's interior. That is, the molten magma gets boiled and that erupts out suddenly on the surface of the earth is called as a volcano. Then earthquake, how does earthquake take place? Inside the crust, what happens? There are some plates, right? See, when we are standing on the earth, on this place, we see that there is our both the feet are equal. Okay? But if sudden happens, there is something, when you go on the road, you see that if the road is very nice, very flat, you go in a same way, same sequence. But when you see that the road is not good, it has got some ups and downs, then what happens? You will also move in the same way how the ups and downs are there. So what I mean to say here is the movement of the lithospheric plates. So inside the earth's crust, there are different layers, I told you. So when these layers, they are being placed in the form of plates like this. So when these plates goes up and down, or when they touch each other, or when they come like this and like this, when it happens, there is imbalance in the place of the earth, then what happens? There will be some movements on the surface of the earth. Then it causes earthquake or vibrations. So here, the movement of the lithospheric plates causing vibrations on the surface of the earth are called as earthquake. Now, how do I represent this in the form of what do you say? Picture. Suppose, say for example, this is the molten magma here. Right, and there are different types of plates here. Where these different plates, there is imbalance in these different plates, then what happens? There is vibrations is being produced on the surface of the earth. So this where the thing is being moving inside the earth, this is called as a focus point. This is a focus point. And same exactly what is happening here inside the crust, that particular point or that particular place, we call it as a focus. And then just opposite to it, from where the things are coming out or from where the lava gets exit, then that exact place we call it as a epicenter. And the plates which are there here inside the earth, those causes what? Those causes earthquakes or vibrations. The imbalance in the plates into the earth's crust causes vibrations. Understanding, children? The imbalance into the plates of the earth's crust causes vibrations, and that point we call down here is called as a focus point. The same point that comes on the surface of the earth, we call it as a epicenter. The waves are coming out of it. Seismic waves we call. So that is called as earthquake. Earthquake is nothing but the sudden movement on the surface of the earth due to the vibrations into the crust of the earth. This very simple you have to understand. How earthquakes are being formed? Earthquakes are being formed when the lithospheric movement, when the lithospheric plates are imbalanced, or there is some imbalance between the lithospheric plates into the earth's crust, then it forms the earthquakes. It causes vibrations. And when vibration causes, then we could see that there is sudden movement on the surface of the earth. Plants will be moving, building will be moving, we feel like as if some giddiness is happening to us. All that is called as an earthquake. So it is given in your textbook for you all. So once again, I read it for you. The point on the earth's surface vertically above the seismic focus is called as an epicenter, and the scientific study of the earthquake is called as seismology. The origin, time, velocity and direction of the seismic waves are recorded by the instrument known as the seismograph. So what is the instrument that we are using to measure the waves? That is called as the seismograph. Daily I am repeating the class again and again because you need to understand the things very nicely. Then what are the causes of the earthquake? Here in the textbook you see plate tectonics. I said you that here it is given in the form of a picture you see. Okay, what I said you now in the simple two lines that is being displayed in the actions of the earthquake. Plate tectonics. The earth's crust consists of many major and minor plates. These plates are not stationary. The plate boundaries are dynamic places and are the primary location of the earthquake activity. That is called as circumspecific belt. See here, they have shown in the form of a picture here, like this is made, and earth is having different types of plates here. Here, like this is shown, Here, this is the focus point. Then say exactly that comes out here. This is called as epicenter. Why earthquake happens, or what are the reasons for earthquake to take place? The first point is because of the plates that are not stationary. There is movement inside the earth's crust. The plates are moving inside the earth's crust, and those movement of the crust, movement of the plates causes vibration, and then it gives out the earthquake. Then volcanic eruptions. Volcanic earthquakes are caused by gas explosions. So volcanic explosions are causes gas explosions also. Then faulting. A fault consists of a fracture in a rock along with a great deal of displacement takes place. And earthquakes occur when movement of plates takes place along the line of fracture. That is San Andreas Fault of California in USA. So it's an example they have given you for here about the causes of the earthquake. Then man-made. How earthquakes happens? Because of the man-made factors also. One is over-interaction of man with nature is also one of the main causes of the occurrence of many of the earthquakes. So the extraction of the minerals, man is extracting the minerals from the surface of the earth. Because of these things also, there is deep mining, underground mining is there, and all these causes construction of the huge damages and nuclear tests. Because of all these man-made factors also, we can say that there will be earthquakes on the surface of the earth. Then earthquake waves. How are the earthquake waves we'll study here? The earthquakes or the seismic waves originate in the seismic focus and travel towards the epicenter in ripples or concentric circles. The three important earthquake waves are primary waves, secondary waves, and the surface waves. Then what are these primary waves? Primary waves are also known as longitudinal or compressional waves. These are the fastest earthquake waves and the first waves to reach the surface. They can pass through the solid, liquid, and gaseous matters. And then second one is secondary waves. The earthquakes passes the wave in three types. One is the primary waves, secondary waves, and the surface waves. Secondary waves are also known as transverse or distortional waves. These waves cannot pass through liquids. They reach the epicenter of the primary waves. Then surface waves. These are the waves that are called long waves. They are the slowest earthquake waves but are responsible for the highest destruction on the surface of the earth. So this we have come to know about the earthquakes. Then we will be discussing about the external forces in the tomorrow's class. Maybe tomorrow we will end up the class of this lithosphere lessons, because it's a very lengthy lesson, so we are going in a very deep way and also in the most easiest way that I can make you to reach understand the topic. Then comes the tsunami. What is the tsunami? The earthquake, I just told you that earthquakes are very destructive, or they are the mass that causes mass destruction. Volcanoes and earthquakes causes mass destruction on the surface of the earth. What kind of mass destructions happen? There will be destruction of the buildings or the fire, or there can be fires in the forest and all such. The earthquakes are very dangerous and very destructive. They cause large-scale deaths, loss to property, landslides, flash floods, damage to bridges, roads, railway lines, etc. Understanding? So, internal forces are the forces that are acting into the earth interior, and then they come out on the surface of the earth in the form of volcanoes and earthquakes. These are the two examples for endogenic forces. Then one more is the tsunami. Tsunami is a large sea wave occasionally experienced along the coast of Japan and in other regions caused by an underwater earthquake. In Japanese language, tsunami means harbor waves. So tsunami is also a harbor wave that passes into the sea or ocean. So we have seen this in the last back. Tsunami had taken place. So in Japanese language, the meaning of this word is harbor waves. The important facts that they have given in the box, children, this may come in the form of what you say, choose the correct answer, that you have to study. Then distribution of earthquake and what are the prone zones, means the areas where earthquakes takes place. The circumpacific belt regions around the Pacific Ocean, Zealand, Philippines, Japan, USA, etc. The Mediterranean belt regions around the Mediterranean Sea, the Himalayan belt, the Shivalik region of India. So these are the internal forces that we have studied. In tomorrow's class, we'll be continuing with the external forces and the remaining part of the lesson that is connected to the rivers and the other landforms that we'll be studying in tomorrow's class. And tomorrow we are going to end up with this lithosphere lesson. Understanding, children? So in a very simple way, I'm going to make you understand. In this lesson, we have studied what are the topics we have covered for you. Once again, I'm putting on the board for you to understand. What we have studied in this lesson is lithosphere, meaning and importance. Then we have studied about Earth's interior and composition. Then about rocks and types of rocks. Then we have studied about forces on the Earth's crust. First one, what we have studied here? Endogenic forces. Then exogenic forces. And in endogenic forces, we have studied about volcanoes, earthquakes, and causes. What are the causes for volcanoes and earthquakes? This much we have covered in this 4 days. So lithosphere means we have studied the outermost solid layer on the surface of the earth. The outermost solid layer on the surface of the earth. Earth's interior comprises of many minerals inside the earth. Those are divided into three different types of layers: the crust, the mantle, and the core. Then we have studied about the rocks and types of rocks. In rocks, we have studied there are three types of rocks. One is igneous rock, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rock. In igneous rocks, we have studied about two types of rocks, intrusive igneous rocks and the extrusive igneous rocks. How igneous rocks are formed, how sedimentary rocks are formed, and how metamorphic rocks are formed. Then we have studied about the forces on the earth crust. The forces on the earth crust or in the earth crust are, one is endogenic forces and the other one is the exogenic forces. Endogenic forces is also called as internal forces and exogenic forces are also called as external forces. In endogenic forces, we have studied about the volcanoes and the earthquakes. What is a volcano? Volcano is a molten material that erupts out suddenly on the surface of the earth. The molten magma that gets boiled into the earth's crust, and then that comes out through the vent or opening with the help of, or through the grater through a vent that is opening. Vent is nothing but what? It's an opening. Opening of the lava that ejects out, that comes out, is called as a or sudden ejection or sudden ejection of the lava, the molten magma that gets boiled into the earth's interior and suddenly it ejects out through a vent or opening is called as a volcano. And volcanoes are of three types: active volcano, dormant volcano and extinct volcano. Active volcano, there is continuous ejection of lava. Dormant volcano, they take place in the past and also they take place in the future. And extinct volcano, they are the volcanoes that happens rare, that does not happen continuously. Those take place in the remote geological periods. So all these we have studied. Then earthquake, what is an earthquake? Earthquake means the movement of the lithospheric plates that causes vibration on the surface of the earth is called as an earthquake. What are the causes of the earthquake? I said you that because of the movement in the lithospheric plates, when the plates are not in a proper place, when they are moving inside, then those plates causes vibration on the surface of the earth and then there is lot of destruction on the surface of the earth. So these are the things that we have covered in today's class. So please children, keep your textbook reading. If you have any doubt, please you can ask, and please do complete your notes. After completion of this lesson, the PDF for this lesson will be sent. So please complete your classwork. And once again, I am telling you, read the textbook twice, thrice, how much you want. You just go on reading the textbook. Whatever once I explain in the online class, when you read the textbook, you will understand very nicely. So two things I am doing here. One is I am explaining, and the other one is I am reading the textbook also for you, so that you can understand. Yet it's the same thing you should also do, children, because it is not only we that we are standing here for you to make the topic to reach to your mind. Interest should come from you, and you should read the textbook and complete your notes and listen to the classes very properly. Then all the things will go very smoothly. Okay, we shall continue in the next session with the remaining topic of this lesson. Thank you.